My beautiful subscribers, welcome back to my channel. This message is for Pisces. Let me turn my thing up some more. Okay, Pisces, sun, moon, rising, and north node. Please only take messages that resonate for you. You will know intuitively if the messages are for you. Do not try to force the messages to fit, please, and thank you. Thank you for the continued love, support, like, shares, and comments. I really do appreciate it. So let's see, sun, moon, rising, and north node for Pisces, spirit guides, universe, ancestors for Pisces. So we got the Seven of Pentacles, reaping with you what you sow, going over your investments, what you give your time and energy to. Okay, going over the people, places, and things that you gave support to or gave support to you with the Seven of Pentacles. Give me more. The Lovers and the Five of Swords. So it's like someone has to compete for your time. Okay, it could be a lover. Or it could be two people competing for you. What's the Lover's card? Five of Cups. I'm hearing that song, I don't wanna spend time no more. Don't let my heart go. I don't know why I'm hearing that song. Okay, what's this Five of Cups? So somebody can have multiple men or multiple lovers? Zoe, go in there, please. Zoe, go in there. The Chariot. Someone could have lost their car. What's this Five of Swords? Or someone could be sad that you're moving on. Four of Cups and the Six of Wands in reverse. What's this Four of Cups? Give me 1 second. Okay, y'all. So it could be a lover. It could be a Gemini, a Cancer, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, or Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. They feel like they have to compete for your time and attention. The Six of Wands in reverse. This person can feel like you don't look at them the same or feel the same. What's the Six of Wands in reverse? The Empress and the Ace of Cups. This person could be feeling like you're saving your love, or it's unrequited, or you're holding out on love. Like you're giving up, you're walking away from it. Okay? And this person could feel as though it's something or someone or somebody else, male or female. Queen of Wands, Queen of Cups, and the Knight of Pentacles. King of Swords. This person could find you attractive or very loving in this single energy. Or this person could be literally giving to two people. I'm hearing cake and eat it too. What's the Empress in reverse? The Two of Cups in reverse and the Two of Wands. What's this Two of Wands? The Hierophant. Someone felt like they lost the opportunity to be in a relationship with you. You and this person can have a calling together with the Hierophant and the Two of Wands. Supposed to be on the same path. It could have been a reason why this person was brought on your path or towards you for a lesson with the Hierophant. Whether it's knowing how to walk away or where you invest your time at. What's this Two of Cups in reverse? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Someone feel like it doesn't feel the same. What's this Two of Cups in reverse? Two of Cups in reverse. Nine of Swords, yeah. Because now you're not checking for them, worrying about them, focused on them, paying them attention. Nine of Swords in reverse. It's like you don't have any anxiety towards the situation. What's this Nine of Swords in reverse? Yeah, the Nine of Wands in reverse. It's like you didn't heal from the situation overall. Yeah, Temperance. Seven of Wands, you're protecting yourself, protecting your energy, your peace. Peace of mind. Ten of Pentacles, Queen of Cups, and the Ace of Swords. So you are in this compassionate energy, is loving, caring, nurturing energy. Or just loving, caring, and nurturing on yourself. Like, just setting boundaries. What's this Nine of Wands in reverse? Nine of Wands in reverse. Yeah, the Eight of Wands. Moving out of that energy that was making you feel like you couldn't achieve anything. Or you want a rise to the occasion. It could have been difficult. But you still grown from the situation. Seven of Pentacles. From this person, place, or thing. What's the Hierophant? You could be receiving a lot of downloads as well. About this lover, this person. Okay, you could have a decision to make with the Two of Wands. I'm hearing final decision. What's this? Yeah, the King of Swords. What's this King of Swords? The Moon card. What's the Moon card? Nine of Cups, King of Wands. So back to what I was saying with the two. Okay, Pisces. Back to what I was saying with the Lover's card. So maybe, Pisces, this is you or someone external to you. Okay? Yeah, Three of Pentacles. It's like you have a choice or a decision to choose between two individuals. Someone could also be secretly doing... energy. Somebody is doing like energy spells, energy work. What's this King of Wands? They're the Hermit. So you, it could be like distance between you and this person. It's no communication. I don't know about her vanish. Vanish. Somebody could be doing a vanishing spell towards a masculine energy. They could be your twin. Yeah. It's like two individuals could be competing in the 5D, the Moon and the Hierophant, over you. But between these two people, it's like someone wants to have their cake and eat it too with the Nine of Cups. Or it could just be a lot of people involved, because I've seen the Five of Wands as well. But some communication will be coming in, whether it's through the dream state, intuitively, through a download. And someone is trying to stop it with the Five of Swords. It's like someone is trying to block it. Okay? Because someone feel like that you are uninterested, you're not attracted to them. This person know that they're losing you and that you're leaving them. What's the hermit called? The Ten of Cups, I'm telling you. This could be someone you got a family with or someone that makes you very much happy. It's like somebody is trying to do a vanishing spell to get rid of someone. Okay? Or someone is trying to look into your life to see if you're happy somewhere else or with someone else. Yeah, the Magician. It's trickery going on in the High Priestess. And the Fool. The Hangman and the Wheel of Fortune. So someone is definitely doing things in the moon. I mean, with the moon. What's this Nine of Cups? Someone could also be trying to hide a family. Someone could have a secret family somewhere. So we got the Emperor in reverse with the Star in reverse. And the Fool came out sideways, okay? So, whatever someone is trying to, like, start over or renew or get another chance about, it's like this person is unhealed with the Star and the Emperor. This person can be unhealthy and bad health. What's the Emperor and the Star card in reverse? It's like someone could be also trying to invade your dream state. Okay? It's like this person just pops up. The Two of Wands, the Moon, and the Nine of Cups. Like Houdini. Someone could be a, what they call him, sir? A djinn? What's this? What's the Emperor and the Star in reverse? Or a shapeshifter? Yeah, the Ace of Swords. That's what this person is. This Emperor and the Star in the reverse. And it could be causing you to be imbalanced with the Empress in reverse. Because the Empress in reverse don't necessarily have to be someone that's not taking care of themselves or they're not in their divinity. It's just, this person is probably fluctuating your moods with the Nine of Cups and the Moon card. And then the Fool card is sideways. So it's like whatever your joy is or happy to go towards or do, it could have you like second guessing yourself with the Two of Wands. Not sure, like, should I do that or should I not do that? It's to keep you in a lack with the Five of Pentacles and the Five of Cups. And a low vibrational energy. That's why I said someone is doing like energy harvesting, energy work, whatever the case may be. But it's like you still moving out of that energy though. You still move out that energy. And we say the Temperance card, so you are protected, Pisces. What's this Eight of Wands, Spirit? Because I guess they don't, the Four of Wands in reverse. Yeah, trying to cause instability, cause you to be unstable, cause you to be unsure about the decisions or choices that you make or how you do things. King of Wands and Judgment. So someone is definitely feeling called to come towards you, but they could be being blocked or being delayed. Okay, this person is still in incognito mode because someone is doing magic on this person as well. Is you? Could be the air sign. We got the Eight of Cups, 1444. What's this Four of Wands in reverse? So, new love and energy is here. It's just being blocked and delayed. What's this 4 months in reverse? I'm telling you. Yeah, to like cause burdens for you. To make it difficult. To make it hard for you. Yes, yeah, 7 of Swords. Causing distractions, delays, blockages, setbacks. What's this 7 of Swords? It's like stealing your joy and happiness, or what? I don't know. 3 of Wands. It's like someone is trying to make a move towards you, 3 of Wands, but it's like someone is stealing that from you, 7 of Swords. What's this 7 of Swords? And then we got the 8 of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. What's the 7 of Swords? Page of Cups in reverse with the 4 of Swords. Someone also could have hid or lied about a child. Or someone is lying or I told you with this hidden family shit. Somebody is hiding a family or hiding you from a family. And it's stressing this person out because whatever it is that they're trying to keep up or keep going or doing is not working. Three of Cups. It's like someone's whole plan is to make a move and go towards this person that they're separated from or at a distance from. Yeah, Knight of Pentacles. But it's obstacles being thrown in this person's way. Like tactics. Someone could also steal information from somebody, from you, or from this person to use against them. So someone is using some form of information that was told to them against them. Could be in court. Could be against friends and family. Could be from a community, a group of people. Yeah, the Queen of Swords. So we got the King and Queen of Swords out here. Six of Cups, Knight of Wands, and Justice. It's like someone keep getting gaslighted or pulled back into a situation from their past. This person is tricky. It's like they know all the right things to say and do to use it against this person.
Hold on, y'all.
Oh, you're right there. Alright. And then it's like this person is hiding something though. With this 4 of Swords in reverse. What's this 4 of Swords in reverse? This is 4 of Swords in reverse. The Queen of Cups. Someone could also be blocked off emotionally or just blocked off in their feelings or just hiding their motives towards a person, place, or thing. Could be a male or female. Take it where it resonates. Then with that Knight of Wands that came out with the Queen of Swords, this person can be like very sexual. Hey, apparently they don't let their boys shop. Equal rights, just because I'm a woman. They can put a lot of sex spells on this person. to drain them energetically so they won't be able to make a move towards you or even act upon on doing such. If this person is still interacting or having sex with this person, you take it where it resonates. It's like this person is using their looks to manipulate this person, to trick this person. What's this Queen of Cups spirit? So that's why I say it's like someone is trying to hide or block or refuse their motives from being revealed. Like they're doing a lot to hide their true motives, their true intentions towards this person, male or female. What's this Queen of Cups? Queen of Cups. Yeah, the devil. It's someone's motives or intentions. What's the devil called? Somebody also could have wanted to share you with someone. Queen of Wands, Three of Wands, and the devil. This is like two energies. Someone could also be trying to snake you out from a distance. Could be a fire sign, Queen of Wands. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Give me more of this Queen of Wands. It's like someone wants you off your throne. Six of Wands and the Empress in reverse. They want you to be, I guess, vulnerable or gullible. So you won't find out or figure out what these people really been doing behind your back or towards you. Yeah, Two of Pentacles to keep you juggling, overthinking. Get the Tower card. A backfire. What's the Queen of Wands? To keep you all in your head overthinking, but the Nine of Swords is in reverse. So if you did have some form of anxiety or in some form of depression or in like a confused mental state, it is like wearing off. So it's like you could have been under some form of a spell for like a second, but it didn't work. Because once you revealed it or you figured it out or you said something, it's like it's gone. That's the truth, Ace of Swords. Because something about your truth is out here. Well, it could be everything. You just place the energies where it is. And then the Tower and the Two of Pentacles came out again. Clarify more on this Queen of Wands spirit. It's like someone wants you to be emotionally withdrawn. Like not in your emotions, not in your feelings. It's like someone is trying to control your emotions and feelings. Or what you do, how you do, the way you think, what you say, whatever. This is crazy. What's this Queen of Wands for Pisces? Yeah, the Hangman in the upright. And the Three of Cups in reverse. This could have literally been like a group of people, but the Three of Cups in reverse. So it's like this coven is being dismantled or being caught up. Because it was just to block you, 10 of Wands. And it could have been very consistent to slow you down. But now it's going back towards them. Why you keep doing that? Ew. What's the Three of Cups in reverse? What's the Three of Cups in reverse? 24 minutes. What's the Three of Cups in reverse for? Yeah, Seven of Wands is being blocked. You are protected. Okay. Your judgment page is full. These people could be sitting back watching to see if it's working. No, it's not. Yeah, now the page of swords is in reverse. What's this page of swords in reverse? Page of swords in reverse for it. Yeah, the ten of swords. Because it's like the same dish they did for you. They keep falling in it. Okay? These could be people from your past or just familiar spirits that people keep trying to, like, shapeshift into different bodies or different energies of people. Like, come on in. Because that's what the magician is for. It's like shape-shifting energies of people. Somebody is fluctuating their energies into different suitors to block you. Ten of Wands. Maybe to miss opportunities, to stay in poverty, to not make good decisions. Yeah, this is a mess. Just to betray you. It's just a bunch of envy, jealousy, and hatred. And it could have been a covenant of people, a group of people, more than one person, male or female. Okay. But it's being dismantled, though, because if the recovery is in reverse and it's being blocked, Seven of Wands, you are protected. Try to literally sacrifice who you really are, and that's the Queen of Cups. You're the true Queen of Cups. So it's like these people are trying to dim your light as being empathic and compassionate and loving, caring, and nurturing. Or always someone that is just very so giving. Whether it's with wisdom, knowledge, or with anything. That's why the devil is here, like trying to control your intentions, your motives, your emotions, how you feel, how you receive messages. Because you are the true Queen of Cups. And Spirit says that's the truth. Okay, King, Queen of Cups, male or female, that's your energy, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. It's like people is so fond of keeping you bondaged or controlled, but all it does is backfire onto them because they dig a bigger hole for their soul to fall into. Okay, it's like you are slaying these people, these demonic energies and entities that keep trying to come up against you to cause blockages and steal, kill, and destroy Seven of Swords. And some of these people are at a distance from you, Three of Wands. Some of these people could be around you in your everyday. Okay. I guess the thought of you, like, irritates their soul. It's funny because it's like the way how my spirit guy said it. It's like you irritate their soul. What's this Ten of Swords? 2828 on the clock. So 2828 could be significant. Look up that number. That angelic number. What's the Ten of Swords? You irritate these people. Because you just keep pulling up to the scene with your ceiling missing. And they just like, what? Yeah, Ten of Pentacles. This is your legacy that you're supposed to build, create, and to continue to keep growing and building. Okay? It's like they look over and they see you growing and growing. And you look over and you see them. They are depressed, sad, miserable, in poverty, okay, still in the same low vibrational energy and mindset and tactics. When would these people ever grow or learn their lesson? They're not doing no type of healing, so they're trying to stop, block your healing and your ascension, because they're not ascending, they are descending. And the more that they continue to descend, they're calling on low vibrational ancestors. They is not these people here. What's this Ten of Swords? Like, your ascension, like, is bothering these people. What's this Ten of Swords, Spirit? And then I'm out of here. What's this Ten of Swords, please and thank you? Yeah, the Two of Swords. Okay, trying to block you, blind you from the truth, from knowing what you already know, Pisces. Okay? From not reaching or going down the path that you're destined or called to be on with the Hierophant. Okay? And you hear the horn? So this your message, Pisces. I don't know what these people got going on, but make sure you guys like, share, comment, as well as subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit that bell notification. Peace.